Hi everyone. In this video, I'll be showing you how to create an infinite loop in Java. So I'll be showing you three ways how you can do this, and also I'll show you how to control or break this loop. So let's get started. So first, let me create the infinite loop by using for. Okay. So just come here and type for. Just open circular bracket and just put two semicolon inside it. That's it. So just open curly bracket and here I will just put system not out. Dot just print, okay, and let me just print loop. Okay, just having the print statement as an indicator for our infinite loop, so just semicolon, and let me just save it now, and I will go to the terminal. Let me just compile it and run it. So here you can see it's going on infinitely. You can see in the output. So to stop this, just control C. Yeah, it has stopped now. Okay. So just do CLS. Yeah. So this is how you create using the first method. And also if you add int I equal to 0 and just have a condition as I less than 1, that's it. You are not, we are not giving here an increment operator, but this will also act as an infinite loop, because since there is no increment operator, I value will remain as 0 forever. So I will be 0 forever. This condition I less than will be true forever as well. So this basically becomes an infinite loop, and we will be getting this loop printed infinitely. So let me also now save this and recompile and run it again. Yeah, same infinite loop we are getting for that. Yeah, it's a stop. So this is by using for loop, but I guess majority of the people will be using while loop for creating infinite loop. I don't know why. So I'll be showing you while loop, which is the most common way. So let me just remove this. So for while loop, it's pretty simple as well. Let me just have that print state. Okay, just copy this and now remove this. So it's going to be while within bracket, we are just going to put true. Okay, that's it. And let's have that print statement. Saving it, clearing it, and again recompiling it. No errors. And again, so same result. This is the simplest way of creating an infinite loop by using while. This is like common for all the programming languages, whether it's Python, C++, same while loop, same true, and same infinite loop as well. So now let us see how we can control this infinite loop over here. So for this, we need to basically get a number as an input from the user. So for that, we will be using scanner, okay, to basically input number. So it's going to be import java.util.astic, because inside util only scanner class is present. So we will be getting input inside the while loop. So it's going to be capital S scanner, let S be my scanner, equal to new scanner, and it's going to be system.in, and in the next line I'm going to get the number. So let me have a print statement also. Well, move this and I will have enter a number like that, and in the next line basically I will just input that number from the user. So it's going to be int n equal to our scanner name, which is s dot next int semicolon. So basically now we are done. So now we need to place our break statement. So for those who don't know about break, break is a statement that is used to terminate a loop. Okay, it just comes out of our loop. So since we are having this while loop default set to true, this will be keep on running. So in order to terminate or come out of this loop, we will be using the break statement over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to have a simple if condition. So if our n is equal to, let me put 5, okay, n is equal to 5, I am just going to break this loop. So in case if you are having any program that you want to run infinitely, or any application that you want to run infinitely, you can just have this code and place your program or application code below this if condition. Okay, you can just place it over here. So now let me explain how this code is going to work. So this while will run for infinitely. We will be getting the number as an input for each iteration of this while loop. So we can enter whatever number we want, but if our number is 5, I have set it as 5. You can set it to a string as well. You can do whatever you want. I have set it as 5 just for a demo purpose. So if this number is equal to 5, this break statement will be executed and this while loop terminates. So for that, I will be having here some print statement as well. Okay, yeah, I will just put while loop terminated like that. Yeah, I hope this made sense. So I'm saving it now, and let me just compile and run it. So here it's asking enter a number. So I will just go with 1. Again, it will come because the number is not equal to 5. So why the loop should break basically. And we also won't be getting this, okay? Because the program control is still inside this while loop. It has not come out of the while loop, okay? So I will enter some other number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Still not. But if I enter 5, boom, the loop terminates. We are coming outside this while loop and this is getting printed and our program is also getting terminated. So this is one of the simplest ways of controlling a while loop and breaking out of it. And I have shown you three ways, but I will also show you an additional way. You can't call this as a loop, but you can call this as an infinite recursive function, okay? Just a bonus, you can watch this if you wanna like gain some more knowledge, okay? So it's going to be, I'm just going to have a function. So let it be static void. I'll just copy this. Static void, I will just name it as fun and I will just have this and let me also have a print statement. Print, I'll just put I am fun or yeah, that's fine and I will call that function over here. So normal stuff, I guess I'm just having a function and calling it over here. Yeah, here it's gone. So if I just now run it, yeah, everything is fine, right? So in order to make this infinite, really simple, just take this and put this inside this, okay? This is like an infinite recursive call because at first this main function will be getting executed and inside this main function we have this fun, okay? This function. So this function is getting called at first and it goes over here. I am fun will be getting printed and again this function is getting called. So again it goes to this calling, it calls this function, gets printed, again calls, prints, calls, prints, calls, and just goes on infinitely. I guess this will terminate some, there is some kind of stack memory. So if that memory is over, this program will just stop. It will break automatically because of insufficient memory in the stack. Try and see, okay, what happens. So yeah, I am running it. Yeah, so here you can see I'm getting this call infinitely and after some time it will get terminated. The reason I told you earlier, there is some stack, insufficient stack memory over here. So that's why it just terminates off. So this is some of the least common way to create an infinite program to run. When you can accidentally make this error, like you don't have a return statement or a terminating condition for your recursive function. So this is the video and I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also done many other Java videos and as well as in C, C++, Python, Blender, Unity, React.js, Node.js, MySQL queries as well. So do check them. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.